ओम अज्ञानातिमिरान्धस्या ज्ञानाञ्जनाशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। नमाम विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्त स्वामीति नामिने। नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे करवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषवाणी पाश्चात्यादेशतारिणे। श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानन्द श्री अद्वैत गदाधर Okay, so let's, yes?
My other friend had joined the call for the first time.
Oh, very nice. What's your name? I can see you. Can you show your face? What's your name?
Jagdish.
Jagdish. Welcome. Thank you for joining the call today.
Okay.
Okay. Do you know the Hare Krishna Mahamantra, Jagdish? This is the Hare Krishna Mahamantra. Can you see on the screen?
Yeah.
Okay. So we are going to say this Hare Krishna Mahamantra 15 times. So everybody is going to chant together. So please chant along with us. Okay. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Okay. So, let's all take this as a point of inspiration and chant at least one round a day. Okay, so those who are not chanting already, please start chanting one round of Hare Krishna Mahamantra, which is 108 times. That constitutes one round, okay? Okay. So, let's move on to our shloka. How many of you have already memorized this verse?
Ramachandra, Jagannath.
Okay, so Ramachandra, please go first.
Krishna Varam Krishna Krishna Sangopangata
Sadasadam Yagnai Sankirtana Praya Yajantihi Sumedashaha.
Okay, Jagannath, you want to recite?
Okay. Krishnavam Krishnavarnam Tusha Krishnam Sango Pangasa Pasaram Yagnai Sankirtane Praya Yajantihi Sumedashaha.
Very nice recitation.
Can I try?
Krishnavarnam
Tusha. Who's this?
Ashutosh,
yes, go ahead.
Krishna Varnam Tusha Krishnam Sangha Pagasra Prasadam Yagna Sankirtana Praye Yajantihi Sumedasha.
Very nice, Ashutosh. Everybody's trying very nicely. Some of you are making a little bit of mistake with the second one. Sangopangastra Parshadam. Okay, so who else wants to try?
Mataji, this is Haridas.
Okay, Haridas, please go ahead.
Krishnam Krishnam Sango Pangasa Parshadam Yada Isa Yagna Isam Ketan Apply Yajanti Sumeta Saha.
Very nice, Haridas. Very nice try. Who else wants to try? Okay, so let's read the translation. In the age of Kali, intelligent persons perform congregational chanting to worship the incarnation of Godhead, who constantly sings the names of Krishna. Although his complexion is not blackish, he is Krishna himself. He is accompanied by his associates, servants, weapons, and confidential companions. So anybody wants to explain what this means? Okay, let me ask you a question. Why does
it... They're trying to say that, in the age of Kali, to reach Krishna, you have to do congregational chanting or chanting.
Mm-hmm. Very nice. Who's this?
Ashutosh.
Very nice explanation, Ashutosh. Yes, that is the meaning. Why does Krishna say intelligent persons? Why, any other person who does not chant is considered not intelligent? Because there are so many people in the world, the scientists, so many people who achieve so many things in the material platform, like, you know, in academics, in science, and so many things. So are they not considered as intelligent?
They are. They call them intelligent people because they know Krishna.
Yes, they know Krishna, but why only people who know about Krishna and who chant, they're considered as intelligent? Because whatever we achieve on the material platform, say, as I said, mentioned in academics or in science or in maths or in whatever platform, you know, in technology, computers, whatever people achieve on the material platform, they are still not considered intelligent because everything in the material world is temporary and everything is going to finish one day. It is going to get exhausted. And when we die, those achievements are not going to come along with us, with our soul. So the only thing that we can carry along with our soul is our devotional credits. So whatever devotional service we do, that is permanent. That's going to be in our bank account. Whatever other things we achieve, it's not going to be there with us. So anything that we do to improve our temporary material life is still not a very intelligent thing to do. Because when we die, we have to address the problem of birth and death. When we die, we still have to have some credits with us. So the only thing that will come along is devotional credits. That's why people who perform congregational chanting, they are considered intelligent. Did everyone understand what I said?
Yes.
So only people who do good to their souls, see, intelligent people, they think about the long run. They don't just think about the immediate benefit. They think about their long-term benefit. And what is our long-term benefit? We just not think about this lifetime. We also think about next lifetime and what's going to happen in our future. So that's why they are called as intelligent. Okay? Okay, let's move on to the next shloka, which is Srimad Bhagavatam 12.3.52.
Hare Krishna Mataji.
Yes?
Chandra.
But what if you don't have...
Hare Krishna Mataji, this is Krishna.
I'm sorry, who was that asking the question?
Ashutosh,
yes, go ahead. I can't hear Ashutosh. Can you others please mute your phones?
Never let me say.
Yes, Ashutosh, go ahead.
Godhead. Back to Godhead.
What was the first part of the question, Ashutosh?
What if you don't have a next life? What if you don't have a next life and you're going back to Godhead?
Yes, that's exactly what I'm talking about. So you don't want to take a next birth. And so you're thinking about how I can avoid the next birth, because next birth, if it happens, we're not sure if we are going to, what we are going to do, because that is not fully in our hands. So we don't want to take that risk. So if we can think of Krishna and if we can, earn enough devotional credits so that we can go back to Godhead in this very lifetime, then that is a very intelligent thing to do.
Thank you.
Hare Krishna. Thank you for asking that. So, who was that? It was Krishna?
Yes.
Ramachandra.
Yes. Ramachandra, you wanted to say the shloka?
Yes, Mataji.
I wanted to.
Okay. Krishna, you can go ahead first.
Krishna yadhyayato vishnum tretayam yajatomakai dvapare pavicharjyarya kalau taddarikesanat.
Very nice, Krishna. Thank you. Ramachandra, you can go ahead. Very nice, Ramachandra. Ashutosh, yes, go ahead.
Okay.
Akshita?
We discussed how this world is kept by law, by calling it Uttalayam. So please read.
Very nice, Ashutosh. Akshita, yes. Akshita, go ahead.
Tayato Vishnum Tretayam Yajatomake Dvapare Parichayayam Kalo Taddari Kirtanam.
Thank you, Akshita. Very nice. I can simultaneously hear some noise, like a lecture. Can someone... okay. Thank you. Thank you for muting the phone. Okay. Who else wants to recite the shloka?
Aurav,
go ahead. Thank you, Aura. Very nice recitation. Who is this?
Jagannath.
Yes, Jagannath, go ahead.
Kateyat Jayato Vishnum Pretayam Yajato Makehi Vapare Parichayayam Kalotad Dari Hari Kirtanat.
Very nice. Thank you. Very nice recitation, Jagannath. Okay. So, anybody else wants to recite?
Mataji, this is Haridas. Kritai is that Vishnu.
Very nice, Haridas. So many of you have recited so beautifully. Thank you for taking that effort. And again, this is an interesting shloka. Let me read the translation first. Whatever result was obtained in Satya Yuga by meditating on Vishnu, in Treta Yuga, by performing sacrifices, and in Dwapara Yuga, by serving the Lord's lotus feet, can be obtained in Kali Yuga simply by chanting the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. Okay. So, in this shloka, okay, so does somebody want to explain what the meaning of the shloka is?
Krishna!
It's very straightforward. Yes, Krishna.
Whatever result was obtained,
So what are we talking about here, Krishna? We are talking about the Yuga Dharma, no? Yeah, that's right. So that Hare Krishna Maha Mantra is in Kali Yuga. But I just wanted to ask a question: that have we not heard about people who have done meditation? Or doing sacrifices, or you know, serving the Lord's lotus feet in Kali Yuga.
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Yes.
So it basically means that instead of like meditating for like hundreds of years and like doing it for so long, you can simply just chant the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra instead of meditating for so long.
Yeah, thank you. And why is it so that it's easier to chant Hare Krishna than on meditating? Why do they recommend for Kali Yuga?
Hare Krishna Mataji, this is Ramachandra.
Mm-hmm.
Because when you chant Lord Krishna's mantra, it gives you benefit. When you chant Lord Ram's mantra, it gives you benefit. But when you chant the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, it gives you the double benefit.
That's right. Very nice. So meditation, it requires a lot of time. You have to meditate for a long number of years. You have to sit in a particular position. You have to fast and you have to be very austere. And in Kali Yuga, that's not possible because people have very short lifespans. So although you have heard about people meditating, it's not going to turn out successful because it's very difficult in Kali Yuga because of short lifespan and because of so many other shortcomings. Same thing with fire sacrifices. We have seen people doing fire sacrifices, but the ingredients are not pure. So it's not going to give the same result as it was done in Treta Yuga. Same with Bapara Yuga. The Archanam, that is the worship of the deities in temple. We have seen people doing temple worship, but again, it's not going to be as perfect as it could be done in Dwapara Yuga because of the process. So the easiest thing and very appropriate thing for Kali Yuga is chanting the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. So will you all remember this?
Anyway.
Yes, Mataji.
Okay,
yes,
very nice. So let's move on to the topic for today, which is the lesson 4. It begins with the word respect to elders. So when we say elderly, what does it mean? People who are elderly.
Older in age.
Those who are older in age. So even a sibling, like a brother or sister who is older in age, are they're considered as elder, not elderly. So elderly means somebody who's really, really older in age, right? Really like a grandmother or an aunt or an uncle or mother or father, something like that, right? Okay, so how do we have to treat, Jagdish and Akshita, can you please maintain some silence? Thank you. Okay, so how do we have to treat elderly people? We have to treat elderly people with?
Great respect.
Great respect. Okay. So this word respect comes into this picture. So we're going to see in detail what respect means. So when we see elderly people, we have to understand that they have experienced a lot in life and they can share their wisdom with us. So we can always ask them questions. We don't have to hesitate and we'll be surprised to find their answers. It will answer our questions even if we had some. Okay? So elderly people have more experience and so we can ask them questions and we can learn from their knowledge. Okay? So, we are going to see that even Lord Krishna showed respect to his father. If you have seen the childhood pastimes of Krishna, he carried his father's sandals or the footwear on the top of his head. And why did he carry it on the top of the head? That was a sign of respect to his father. So, what other signs you have understood to show respect to elders? How can you show respect to your elders?
Dandavat.
Usually, dandavat. Dandavat. What does dandavat mean?
You bow down to them.
Bow down. Yes, bow down to your elders. And then, what else? How else can you show your respect to elders?
Give them a greeting.
By helping them.
Helping them in certain jobs.
Helping them in certain jobs. So whenever they say something, you don't really procrastinate, you don't delay it, you do it immediately. By doing that, you are showing your respect.
Give them a greeting.
Give them a greeting. Yes, very nice.
Talk to the children.
I'm sorry.
By listening to them.
By listening to them. Yes, listening to their instructions. Very nice. What else?
By sharing prasadam.
Serving prasadam. Very nice. Yes, serving prasadam. You all have very nice idea about what respect means. Okay. So because Lord Chaitanya was Krishna himself, he also showed a lot of humility and respect to others. So we are going to see what this word respect means. So having said about respect, can somebody explain to me what respect means?
Treat them nice.
Treat them nice, yes.
Be kind.
Be kind.
Treat them
how you want to be treated.
Treat them how you want to be treated.
Give them what they want.
Treat them like God.
Yes, that's true, especially with elders. Okay, so there are so many words that can, you know, indicate the meaning of respect. So we're going to see them one by one. Okay, so the first word which is there here mentioned is reverence. So who knows the meaning of the word reverence? Reverence means deep respect for someone or something. Not just simple. See, respect, you, as you said, treat them like the way you want to be treated. But for elders, it has to be more than that. Not just how you want to be treated. You should treat elders with more respect. Okay, so that reverence is a deep respect. So really, really very, you should be very humble. That's the meaning. And admiration. How do you understand admiration to be?
You admire somebody.
Admire somebody, yes.
Admire someone.
Yeah. What does it mean by admiring? They have acted
to somebody.
Yes, that's right. So they have acted in a way to impress you, right? So they are impressive and you feel like giving them more respect. Right? That is admiration. By giving them, how do you admire people? Sometimes you can admire people by giving them good words, right? Wow, you have done this so nice. And I really feel so nice to hear this. And I feel so happy to learn from you. You can give admiration like this, no? By words, by sweet words. And consideration. What is consideration? To consider. Yes.
To consider.
What does it mean to be considerate? You reward someone.
To consider their feelings.
Yes, to consider them, their feelings. So consideration, in this context, it means a reward. So when you consider, when you use the word consideration, it's like reward. How do you reward them? By showing respect. So respect is a kind of reward too. When you want to show your admiration and your care and your reverence to someone, then you can reward them with respectful words and respectful actions, okay? That's a kind of reward, okay? So then what is difference? So respect here indicates two things. One is you have to show that you are humble. And when you bow down to someone, you are showing that I am lower than you. So deference here means humble submission. So you are bowing down and you are becoming humble. And then you are considering the other person to be great. So that these are the two aspects in respect, okay? One is humble humility, and the second thing is showing the other person's greatness. Okay, the fourth word here is, the fifth word is regard. Regard here means that when you have a regard for someone, you think of a person in a specific way. So when you have regard for a person, you really think of that person to be very nice, of someone whom you think is worthy of respect. So it's all kind of very close to each other in meaning, but there is slight difference as well. That's why we are seeing in detail. Okay? Remember these words. Okay, the next one is honor. What does honor mean?
It means to tell the truth.
Oh, that is being honest. Honor. Honor means, it ends with an R. This means high respect. So you honor someone. See, when in those days, sannyasis used to come home, they used to make them sit in a high chair or a high, you know, seat, and then they used to wash their feet. Pada puja, they call it. They used to wash their feet with water. So these things are, you know, giving them high respect. And then they will sprinkle the water on their head. The water with which they wash the sannyasi's feet, they will sprinkle on their head as a sign of respect, as a sign of being humble, to show that you are great and I am really, really humble in front of you. So these things are also aspects of showing respect. Then the last one is value. What does value mean with regard to respect?
What
is the meaning of value here? Value, what does it mean when you value something or someone?
Saving something. It's important to you.
Important. Very nice. That's the word. So you are giving importance to someone. So when you make them, when you honor them, when you show respect, you make them feel important. Yeah, they are the most important. When in a certain function, sometimes they invite some chief guests, right? Maybe a function at school or maybe a function at some other program. Sometimes they invite somebody as chief guest. So although there are so many guests to come and see the program, there is one chief guest. He is given the utmost importance. He is given the highest importance in that program. So that is a sign of respect that people show to that person. So that's where the word value comes here. Value is giving them very important position. Okay. Next one is how Lord Chaitanya was in Jagannath Puri. And there is a pastime that happened there. So when Lord Chaitanya was in Jagannath Puri, he went to see the Lord daily. And one day, as he was standing in a huge crowd, he was standing behind a pillar of Garuda to view the deities. But there were a lot of people, so he could not really see the deities properly. And he saw that an elderly woman from Orissa was eager to see the Lord. And then, what did she do? Because she could not see the deities because of the huge crowd, she wanted to see Lord Jagannath very eagerly. So what did she do? She climbed the pillar behind which Lord Chaitanya was standing. And by mistake, because she was wanting to see the Lord, she did not even realize, and she placed her foot on Lord Chaitanya. So she climbed the pillar and she placed the feet on Lord Chaitanya. And then suddenly when Govinda, the personal secretary of Lord Chaitanya, he saw this, he got furious, he got angry. And then he said to the woman to quickly come down. He said, how can you do this? Please come down. You're standing on Lord Chaitanya. And then, you know, Lord Chaitanya, he said, he chastised his servant. He scolded him and he said, it's okay, don't stop her. If she wants to see, please let her see Lord Jagannath. It's okay, I don't mind it. And then the woman realized her mistake and she quickly got down. And then, but Lord Chaitanya, he is such a great person. He's Krishna himself. But he praised the woman and he said that how fortunate this woman is. I don't have the eagerness which she wants to see Lord Jagannath. I don't have that much eagerness. See how humble he is. That is the meaning of humility. That although somebody is kind of, it is a disrespectful act, right? That the somebody was standing on Lord Chaitanya. That is a disrespectful thing. But he did not want any respect. He was trying to be humble and he was appreciating that she is so eager to not see Lord Jagannath. I don't even have that much of eagerness or desire. So she is very fortunate. Okay? So that's how Lord Chaitanya showed his humility. Did you understand the word humility?
Yes, Mataji.
Yes, Mataji.
Can somebody quickly tell me what is humility?
Humbleness.
What? Humbleness. So what is the meaning of the word being humble? What does it mean to be humble?
When you're
able to bear things.
When you think, yes.
Like you're God.
You are thinking that you are lower than someone. Yes, that is the meaning of being humble. Very nice. Okay. So the next one is a story, the pilgrim Brahmana. This was a pastime that happened when Lord Chaitanya was a small boy.
I know this story.
As Nimai.
I know this
story. Yes, a lot of you, many of you must be knowing this story because this is a very famous pastime from Lord Chaitanya's childhood. And this is when an elderly Brahmana, he came to Nimai's house, that is Lord, he came to Jagannath Mishra and Sachi Mata's house. And then he actually came to Jagannath Mishra and Sachi Mata's house and he brought a deity, Gopal Krishna. Okay, he always carried this deity with him. So wherever he went, he used to carry Gopal Krishna with him. And he only ate food that was first offered to Gopal. So when he came to Jagannath Mishra's house, Jagannath Mishra gave him all respects, like I was saying. He washed his feet and he offered a place for him to stay. And then he offered to make all arrangements for the Brahmana to cook his offering to Gopal. So the Brahmana said, I don't eat unless I offer my food to Gopal and then after Gopal eats only, I eat. So Jagannath Mishra made sure that he gave him all facilities to cook for Gopal. So what Jagannath Mishra did, he first cleaned the cooking area of his home and then he brought all the pots and utensils to cook and he also brought the ingredients or the bhoga. So now he asked the Brahmana to cook for Gopal. So the Brahmana, he began cooking for Gopal and after cooking the meal, the Brahmana was reciting prayers to offer the food to Gopal Krishna. And then suddenly from somewhere, Nimai came and then he smiled at this Brahmana and then he began to eat the prasad bhoga right in front of him. So before it was offered to Gopal Krishna, Nimai started eating. And this Brahmana got so upset. He said, oh my God, this Nimai, where did he come from? He's eating the food. And then, Jagannath Mishra came and then he was trying to, hold Nimai. And then he said, why did you go here, Nimai? Please, why did you eat this? This is an offense. Please don't do like this. And he was trying to pull Nimai. And then the Brahmana said, it's okay. He's just a small boy. You can forgive him. He just did it by mistake. So then Jagannath Mishra felt bad. And then he said, please forgive me, dear Brahmana. I want you to please cook the food again because I don't want you to be hungry because the Brahmana wouldn't eat until Gopal ate the food. So Jagannath Mishra asked the Brahmana to cook the food again. And then the Brahmana, he started cooking again. This time, Sachi Mata, she took Nimai to the neighbor's house and she held him very tight and she made sure that he doesn't go and spoil the offering of the Brahmana. So the second time, the Brahmana, he began to offer the food. And second time, also, suddenly Nimai appeared from nowhere and then he did the same thing and he began to eat right in front of his eyes. And then again the Brahmana got upset and then he was like sitting and Jagannath Mishra said, I'm so sorry. Again, I don't know how this happened, but please cook again. And then the Brahmana said, it's okay. I decided not to eat. I think the Lord does not want me to eat. That's why this is all happening. I don't blame Nimai. He's just a small boy. He did it by mistake. But I think my Gopal Krishna does not want me to eat today. So it's okay. I will just sleep without eating. And then Vishwarupa came. Nimai's elder brother, Vishwarupa, he suddenly came, and then he was feeling so bad that this happened two times. So he requested the Brahmana the third time to cook the food again. So third time, it was almost midnight, and the Brahmana was already decided it's not going to work out. So, but Vishwarupa requested, and he again did all the preparations, and he was about to offer. And then by this time, it was already midnight. Everybody had fallen asleep, and Nimai's parents were also thinking that Nimai had also fallen asleep. But third time, again, when the Brahmana was about to offer, Nimai came. And this time, the Brahmana was so upset, and then he said, again you have come to spoil my offering. And then Nimai said, you are only calling me to eat this food, and when I come, you are getting upset. So the Brahmana got suddenly shocked to hear this. And then the Brahmana said, I was offering to my Gopal Krishna. And then he said, yes. And then he reveals that he is Krishna himself. So Nimai is none other than? Who is Nimai?
Krishna.
Krishna. So he reveals his original identity. He reveals himself in the form as he is in Vrindavana. Okay? With the Surabhi cow behind him. And with all his Kaustubha gem and ornaments. And with his all his eight arms. He is showing with the conch, disc, lotus flower, club. His original spiritual identity he reveals to the Brahmana. And then the Brahmana faints in happiness. So this is the pastime that happened in Lord Chaitanya's childhood. And this is a story for today. So before we conclude, I just would like to, this is their exercise for you to understand how we can help elderly people. So there are a lot of elderly people who are not able to take care of themselves. So what you can do is, you can visit one of the nursing homes. If you have a group of kids who are interested, you can go together, and when you go, you can make nice cookies, you can offer it to Krishna, and you can take the cookies along with you. You can introduce yourself to the hospital staff, the nurses, and then you can ask their permission. You can ask them, is everybody allowed to have cookies? Because some people may have some restrictions on what they can eat and what they cannot. So you can ask permission, and then while they will be very happy to eat the cookies, and then you can sing a bhajan for them, and you can encourage them to clap. Okay, so they will feel very happy because there is nobody else to take care, and they will feel very lonely. So you can, this is one way you can show your respect to your elderly, to all the elderly people there. Okay, so now we come to our questions. This is from the story. Some of the questions are from story. So why don't you just say two words that mean respect? Can you remember? Let's see. What do you remember? We used almost honor, 7 words.
Reverence, honor, value.
Honor, value, reverence.
Honor, value.
Honor,
value.
Valuable.
Honor, value.
Yes, very nice. You remember so many words. Okay. So the second one is, the pilgrim Brahmana worshipped whom?
Gopal Krishna.
Very nice. Yes. While he was offering his food to the Lord, Dash ate the cooked rice.
Nimai.
Yes, naughty boy, Nimai. The Brahmana cooked the offering how many times?
Three times.
Finally, Nimai revealed himself in his... Finally, Nimai revealed himself in his Dash arm form. Okay, so this is your project for today. Give instances where devotees have shown humility by giving all respects to others or elders from Vedic stories. So you can use Ramayana, you can use Mahabharata, you can use any other story that you know related to Krishna and his devotees. You can give those instances where they have shown humility. I will give you an example. In Dashavatara, you have an instance where Bali Maharaj, he showed his humility and respect to Vamanadeva by saying that, place your third foot on my head. Right? That's a sign of humility, right, that he showed. So you can give such instances, okay? Remember, whatever stories you know, give some examples, okay? That's your project for today. Does anybody have any questions?
No, Mataji.
Okay. So is everything clear?
Yes.
Okay. Mataji. So then we'll conclude here by reciting Vancha Kalpa Tarubhyascha. Vancha Kalpa Tarubhyascha. Kripa Sindhubhya Evacha. Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha. Anantakoti Vaishnavrindaki Jai. Thank you all very much. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna Mataji.